This is Fly Guy back again with Marvel Legends 6-inch reviews of Valkyrie and Thor. Now, this is an older pack. I only just managed to get it. It wasn't available outside the US as yet. So, yeah, been a bit of a pain in the ass to get, but a friend finally picked it up for me. And on clearance, too. So, a bit of an older review, but let's take a look at this one. 7 inches tall for Thor in this version here. And Valkyrie is just over 6 inches, at about 6.5 inches tall. So Thor looks to be the same figure. I unfortunately cannot find my previous release version from Marvel Legends, but it certainly looks pretty identical. Feels a little bigger in my mind. I'm not quite sure what it is, but it certainly looks the same in terms of the transfer down the side, the cape, the pain in the ass piece that falls out the side. So pretty much the same. This time ever we get another really pretty good facial likeness on both the characters. Valkyrie's is kind of there. Chris Hemsworth is kind of there too, but really at this price point, pretty exceptionally good. Let's get a look at the packaging first of all. Standard kind of stuff. We'll start with the back for a change. Why not shake it up? Armed with ancient weapons and legendary strength, these Asgardian warriors proudly defend the legacy of their realm. If you still haven't got this, again, it's pretty much on clearance and Targets in the US. There's the UPC. And Thor Ragnarok on the box with a kind of shine on it. Thor Valkyrie's, Marvel's Valkyrie. And nothing else in the back, just a kind of bluish background, I guess, kind of Jack Kirby-esque colour, and that's it. So Thor comes with two swap-out extra hands, so he's basically got two kind of gripping, creepy, I don't know what you would call that, what would you call that? Something hand? Grabbing hand? Donald Trump grabby hands? Something like that. So two of those, and two kind of gripping action hands. So there we go. So I put a sword in one hand for him and his electricity piece, which is removable, and basically a kind of mesh of, we've seen this before, but I can't remember on which figure it was on, but actually a kind of welcomed version of electricity. There you go. It folds out into a kind of full piece, but then just kind of wraps back around into the circular piece. I can't remember what that was for. Shocker, maybe? No, maybe not. Anyway, this would be great on the Black Series Emperor. We've yet to get a kind of electricity-like Emperor in the Black Series, so I'm sure we'll get one day, but nice piece, nice colour, nice lightning looking piece. I like that, that's very cool indeed. Sword is mega, it's absolutely huge, almost as tall as the figure. We get a very detailed hilt on this handle, as you can see there. Look at all that detail woven into that thing, that's good. Very, very nice indeed. The gold is a little bit too light gold, and it makes it kind of pea yellow gold. A little bit darker would have just been awesome to give that kind of weight. Unfortunately, makes it look more translucent than it does anything else. The rest of the blade is a kind of black underneath, or with a silver underneath, with then a wash over the top. I'm not quite sure what they've done, but it looks good. And kudos Hasbro, you've done a great job on that. Love the handle on this thing. The kind of wooden intricacies that are going on there just keep catching my eye. That's really pretty slick. Chris Hemsworth's facial recognition pretty much is in there, and they've definitely got the facial scanning tech. And as you turn it, it seems like him more and more as you turn, even the little scars and the side of the head and the little flick up at the top of the head there. It's pretty good. If we get a little close up there, you'll see that's some pretty intricate sculpting, man. They've done some good stuff. So the hair is browned then with a kind of blondie wash over the top of it. They've done a really nice job on that. I think that's absolutely exceptional. That is absolutely Chris Hemsworth there, without a doubt. As you move around, though, it kind of becomes a little flat in the sculpt. It looks a little squashed. I may be wrong, but still, look, it's pretty damn flawless. The eyes alone, I mean, Jesus, that's on the money. A little bit of shading on the face, a little bit of dirt, but wow, that's pretty damn good in terms of official sculpt. The rest of the armor, again, as we've pretty much seen before, has this nice red wash down the side of the body. It's really pretty cool, actually, the more I look at it. Same pretty much sculpt. I don't have my other Thor, I'm really sorry to compare it, but it looks pretty much the same. I don't see any major difference that I recall, but lovely little gold brass circular pieces up there. This cape is a bit of a pain in the ass, a little bit of futzing, but it does kind of stay in place if you're posing it on a shelf. But yeah, that's pretty good. That is a pretty good likeness, and lots of intricate little dots and details, which a little bit of silver would have just made that damn thing sing if they'd popped that out there. That's really nice. So, very cool looking figure in terms of articulation overall. Pretty good. Bulge up with the hinge. Really tons of range of movement. I mean, that's ridiculous there. As is that. So, all the way forward. Plenty of movement. Standard stuff. Ball joints. So, with the hinge, it's a little bit stiff straight at the package. That's what she said. And bicep swivel there. Two double joints at the elbows. Down to swivel wrists. And you've got the kind of standard back and forth swivel too. Let me just turn this alarm over off here. You can just see the joint down there, so it's a little hard to see underneath that, but this one is back and forth, side and side. On the other side, in his lightning hand, you can see the joint there, so that's how that hand moves around there. You've got an ab crunch, but the cape gets in the way because it's fixed to the side, so the minute you kind of do the ab crunch, actually it didn't work there, so it stayed in place, it did a good job. I thought it would move. It did before, but it's kind of plugged in now. So, actually, ab crunch, not bad. It doesn't go too far forwards, not too far back. We got a swivel waist, which does go round, and that will pop the cape at some point, although it's still not doing it now, even though it was doing it every single second I was doing this review. There you go. It's popped out up at the top. So, it's a little, yeah, pop in there and a little pop in piece there. It doesn't really work. I know it's really hard for them to do, but and I prefer they just, I don't know. It's working so far, so I really shouldn't bitch too much. Underneath standard kind of stuff, we got a peg joint up there. Swivel up at the top of the thighs. Double joints at the knees. No boot cut, I think. No boot cut. And rocking ankles and peckles for those things Hasbro never really give us. It's a pretty good Chris Hemsworth, I have to say. Far better than the original release with the helmet, the non-removable helmet. We kind of should have really got this likeness and the removable helmet or the helmeted version together, but it's a pretty good figure. I'm quite impressed by this. So, yes, like it has. Well, good job on that figure. Valkyrie, she seems to have captured pretty much the likeness of the character from the movie. The actress has been in everything recently, from Westworld to other movies. When you kind of move it around, yep, captured it. Other times, not so much. But they've done a good job. I think they've captured the eyes very well. That's what they've done very well in the scan, I should say. The armor is outstandingly well done. So we've got a kind of deep, you can see it as I tilt that around, a deep shiny silver overall, then apply like almost gunmetal, then a really intricate silver applied through the rest of the armor, makes this thing pick up, makes it look metallic. The belt is completely movable around there, a little touch of gold on the side. These daggers are immovable, they're glued, they're so tiny to her side. But you can kind of get hands gripped around those knives if you wanted to, or daggers, whatever. But exceptionally well done on the armor and the body and the suit. It's really, really nice. The boots kind of lose it a little bit and just go full on silver. But the rest of that upper armor, I mean, the detail on that alone in the back, it is really superb. It really, really makes it look particularly good. So, dead impressed with that. What I'm not impressed with is the single joint elbows. What we get is basically Stormtrooper First Awakens crappy articulation on that elbow there. Nah, it's just not good. You can't get it any higher, and it just kind of limits the figure. So, I get it. Female figures are smaller, and that's Hasbro's kind of excuse. They have fixed the Pepper Potts figure that's coming out to give double articulation at the elbows, but a lot of it's down to aesthetics and designs, and it's not the easiest thing in the world to do, but yeah. Anyway, she comes with a kind of sword, which is a kind of bluish, sea greenish colour, a little bit of white on the handle, and a little bit of silver at the end. She comes with a scabbard, sheath, I don't know whatever you call it, which does fit, got a little hole at the bottom, but no idea where this goes. It doesn't seem to fit on the figure in any way, so the only thing you can kind of do is have that kind of pose where she's withdrawing a sword like Sue. Otherwise, it just becomes an unwanted accessory. So, yeah, it doesn't really work, I think. But they've tried. So, yeah, there you go. So it does eventually go all the way into the kind of scabbard if you want to have it that way. Scabbard, I think, is for small daggers, but you get the idea overall. Facial sculpt and the hair, again, particularly good. She's kind of limited by where she can move with the hair, but it's not too bad. no real major restrictions. I think that's still pretty fair overall. And this cape is really just kind of one big giant, well, flap again. It's always about the flaps, which really doesn't get in the way, and it's really not a problem. So quite impressed overall. Great armor, love the paint. Really stonking job on that overall. I think they've done an exceptionally good job, far and beyond even the little daggered sheath, whatever, just allows that little bit of sea green to come from the sword there. Just really, really good. They're really getting the kind of the design's really great from the movies. The movie quality figures are really up in the game. Lots of nice details in her hair too. This is a great set. It really is. So very pleased with this. Articulation, she can move her head not that far back because of the hair, and about that far forward. So there's plenty of movement. Range on the arms, ball joint with a hinge up at the top there, single joints at the elbows, standard stuff, swivel and back and forth on the sword. Let me get that out of the way. Sorry folks, we're doing it live as usual. There you go, so you can see the extra swivel. A little bit loose on the wrists, but still good. Upper ab crunch is kind of limited, really. It doesn't really go, it's more kind of swivel, and there's no extra ab crunch as such going on. We do get a swivel waist buried underneath the suit. It's kind of hard to see. Pec holes up at the top. You get a swivel on the thigh. Double joints at the knees. And rocking, very rocking ankles. And pec holes for those things that Hasbro never give us. A great set, especially on clearance. I'm very impressed with this. Thank you to my buddy, you know who you are, for picking this up. And I'm glad I didn't miss out, because these are very impressive movie figures. I love the little transfers and details. Let us know what you think of this pack. We'll put a link in the description below where you can go and pick it up. And that's it. We'll see more Marvel Legends and 6-inch Black Series figures coming up, both here for review and on the 6-inch show, the show we do with Matt from Instagram, Star Wars The Black Series, where we talk about everything Star Wars Black Series, Marvel Legends, a little bit of SH Figure Arts, and more. We'll see for other reviews coming up. Cheers.